Guys, I'm back with another video. Hey y'all, so as y'all know, I don't have my monkey anymore, but I still gotta keep you guys informed, you know, for the people out there who still want one. So I'm gonna break it down. In this video, I'm gonna give you guys really 10 reasons not to buy a marmoset monkey. Let's get straight into it. Number one, the price. You're gonna be putting up about anywhere between, you know, $3,000 to $5,000. That's just to buy it. That's not even including the cage, which is gonna run you more money. The veterinary bills, it's gonna run you more money. Then on top of that, you gotta factor in food as well, because they eat just very similar to us. They're gonna have to have a very strict diet, you know, rice, you know, whole foods. You can't, it's no bag food like a dog or a cat, so you really can't get lazy on them. You're gonna need fresh cut vegetables. They're gonna need fresh food. That's just the way it is. If you don't like that, a monkey might not be for you. That's number one. Number two, time and commitment. They're gonna take a lot of your time. When you first get your marmoset monkey, you're gonna have to be with them most of the day, if not all of the time. Usually every 2 to 4 hours, you're gonna be bottle feeding them. And that's a lot. So that means if you have a job, you gotta somehow be able to figure out how you're gonna bring them where. With my marmoset, I actually brought her with me, brought her to my job. So it played out perfectly that way. But for other people, if you're in school or if you have a second job or just a job, you're gonna find that tough to come up with that time to bottle feed her. And you have to be the one to bottle feed her, because that's when the bonding takes place. So you want them to bond to you, so you want to be the one feeding them. And it really just goes off the first point, but you're gonna be having to spend a lot of time, especially playtime. They're gonna wanna be with you, around you the whole time. So usually when she's at home, my marmoset monkey, I had her in my bed with me, or she was running around. She doesn't really spend that much time in a cage because she's a monkey and she needs a lot of space. Unless you're gonna get something like a room for them then, but if most people, they're not able to get a room. So a cage that's big enough is very unlikely. So it's best to have them roam outside of the cage a lot of the time. So you're gonna need a lot of space and a lot of room because of that. Number four, this goes on the cost, but the cost of diapers, it's just like having a child. So those diapers are gonna start to add up after a while. And you have to buy special care diapers because they need very specific diapers because they're so small. So they're gonna have to have some premature diapers, really custom ordered. Not a whole lot of places carry them. Even in stores, they don't carry them. So that's gonna be a struggle in itself. All right, number five. So marmoset monkeys bond, but they don't bond particularly to a group of people. I'd say they bond more to 1 to 3 people, more likely 1 to 2 people. And so that becomes a challenge. So if you do have a family, they can pick and choose who they might, you know, who they might like and who they might not like. So then that can become a big problem, because if you have a significant other that the marmoset monkey doesn't like, now you're stuck picking between the two, and that's never a good position to be in. And it is a wild animal, so if it doesn't like somebody, it will make it known. Not that they're vicious at all, but again, just like anything else, if it doesn't like someone, it just doesn't like them. They have these razor sharp mini teeth, but so they can draw blood if they do bite. And I've experienced it. It's not super painful, but you don't want to be bitten again. All right, where are we? Number six. Okay, if you have pets, that might be a no-no, because if they grow up together, it makes it easier to acclimate to each other. But if you want to get a dog or a cat later on down the lines, after the marmoset monkey has already grown up and grown into his ways, you may find that very difficult. That, again, that could be a problem, because marmoset monkeys, they like to be out all day, same thing with you, and they like to spend time that way. So if they're not out in that way, and you want them that way so that they can get, is, you know, used to people, how we're getting in there. So number seven, vacation. It's gonna be very difficult to take a vacation, because when you have a marmoset monkey, again, they're gonna bond to you and maybe one other person, maybe 1 or 2 other people. So then you can find it very difficult to go on vacation for these couple of reasons here. If you want to go on a trip, you're gonna have to find someone to watch your monkey. A lot of people aren't gonna be able to just watch a marmoset monkey because they're not very easy to deal with. And that person's gonna have to wake up early in the morning, throw on a diaper, feed her food, change your diaper, feed her more food, change your diaper again, and feed her again. All while playing with her, and all while hoping that marmoset monkey actually allows, you know, actually likes the person that's babysitting her. If you do have someone locally, like a veterinarian that allows you to drop her off, that'd be perfect. Or if you have a family member who's familiar with their monkey, then that'd be perfect as well. But for most people, a lot of people don't have that luxury, and so they're stuck with just a friend or somebody, a family member. Number eight, if you're a person that's in college and you want one, or a kid, this is kind of just puts you guys in the same category. I don't really usually recommend them for kids, families with young kids, or people that's in college in general. They're a type of pet that they take a lot of time and commitment. So I'd say it's best for someone, I don't know, maybe who's kind of settled down, don't travel as much. They kind of know they're slowing down and they can just spend their time with, they live 15, you know, 20 years. So they're going to be around for some time. So it's hard to project that much forward, but you just have to make sure your life is organized as much now as possible so that later it will be. But yeah, so like if you have real young kids, that could be a problem, because again, as an adult, you might know how to pick up that marmoset monkey, but a child is not. So they'll just come up to it and they may just grab its tail or something like that, and then it may bite the child. And it's not because your monkey's mean, it's just some might not want to be grabbed on the tail, and the child doesn't know that. So a little child's gonna grab it and then it may bite her, and you see how where the issue may come into play. So they're not necessarily like a dog for the most part. You can come up to most dogs, a lot of dogs you can, and you can, you know, if the dog knows you and you can rub them in certain areas and they're more lenient. She may only want you to pick her up a certain way. Like my marmoset monkey, I had to pick her up certain ways because some ways she didn't like to be picked up. And again, you can do the bite training. I've done everything from flipping the nose, flipping the tail, popping the nose and saying no, and it helps. But again, when it comes down to it, it's still a marmoset monkey, and monkeys are very stubborn to train. And so now it may taper off as they get older and they start to get more used to people, but mine was just about a year old, so she wasn't a dumb when I rehomed her. All right, so here's something to think about. What if you get a marmoset monkey and you guys might not end up bonding immediately? And so from the beginning, she just may bite you and run away from you. Then what are you gonna do? Because for a lot of people, that can become very difficult because you just spent all of this money and you just bought this monkey and it might not be allowing you to hold it. Or for say, what if you have a monkey and then you end up getting a boyfriend or a girlfriend and now it's become jealous of your significant other and it doesn't like her or him? Then where does that leave you? That leaves you in a really weird position. And marmosets, they're not very easy to rehome because, again, they bond strongly to one person. So unless you rehome them really early when they're young, then it's very difficult for them to be rehomed. And what tend to happen is that people just shuffle them around or try to resell them to somebody else. And then now they have a monkey that's been abandoned, and so it's very difficult for that monkey and them, and so it's most likely not going to work, and then it's going to be shuffled around again. Those are the things you kind of have to consider. So I think we've touched on price, you know, having a job, going to school, vacations, the time and commitment it's going to take. Do they bond well with animals? They do. Just to answer the question, do they throw poop? No, they don't throw poop. That's just, you know, a whole, that's not true at all. I've never had mine throw poop. And another thing, number 10, their smell. They don't smell bad. Like, I wouldn't compare them to like a ferret. I wouldn't say they're as bad as a ferret, but you have to remember that in the wild, they scent mark by peeing and they rub their butts on everything they walk on. So if you don't have a diaper on, your whole bed is going to have essentially pee all over it. Not a whole lot, but just like little scent marks every day, everywhere they go. You know, every day you're going to be waking up feeding them diapers or changing their diapers and feeding them food. It's going to require a lot of your time and effort, a lot of money. So if those are the things that you think will work for you, then a marmoset market would make a good pet for you. But for majority of the people out here, they just see that they're cute and cuddly and all that. Yeah, but they're still a wild animal. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll be back.